a musician dead or alive. Man,
David
for me,
Allan Coe. Kill me a woman in
Tennessee. Yeah, John Mayer. Your body is a
wonderland. Are those two completely different co-pilots? Because I feel like... Texas joining us with Bandwagon TV's Joyride. How y'all doing today?
Doing good. How about yourself?
We love making it to Odessa, West Texas, where y'all having a lot of fun. Yeah, hey, y'all get a little crazy out there.
Absolutely.
We're so crazy.
I can tell. It's 9 in the morning right now. I think we're all a little tired. Saturday morning. Real quick, did you guys have a show last night?
No, we did not.
No, but we did... get together and do some writing, you know, for the next album and do a little bit of recording. So last night was still musically involved.
How late is like a session like that? Is it until
like 3 o'clock in the morning?
yeah, pretty late last night.
And any beverages that are involved in a session?
Oh yeah, plenty of beverages.
Yeah,
plenty of water and apple juice.
I think that spiked apple juice is getting to all of us. If y'all don't mind, we want to learn, because we're big fans of No Vacancy. That was a new, you know, your album that came out this year. If you could just let us know a little bit about who you are, musical influences, and really how y'all got together.
We're just a group of musicians that are out of West Texas, and how we got together, I couldn't really tell you. It just kind of happened, and now we're where we're at, and we just play Texas country rock music.
The sound that comes out, it's and would you describe that as Texas country? I know a lot of, you know, there's the whole red dirt and there's the
southern. I'd say it's like, it's more of a Texas country rock type deal. It's definitely going forward. It's turning more into more of a rock band. I don't think it's more of a Texas country band. I mean, you got your red dirt, like your, you know, cross Canadian ragweed. Yeah, I think actually, I mean, you definitely have your Randy Rogers and your Aaron Watson and stuff like that. But I feel like we're more like old school cross Canadian ragweed at this point, like old school Texas country southern rock.
Did you start as a country band, or and so as it progressed, it came more rock?
I mean, we just started as like a little cover band out of a old vacuum shop. That's where we started out at us. Yeah. And then over time, I just said, you know, I have these songs that I've written. Would you like to try them out? And they said, yeah. Ever since then, it's become this other thing. So now we're trying to keep up with making the fans happy and stuff like that. Instead of just playing like Lynyrd Skynyrd covers and stuff like that.
Do you guys play the long version of Freebird?
No, we play the short version. And then we have the really, really long, drawn-out solo at the end.
You've mentioned already a few, the Texas musicians. What does Texas music mean to you? I mean, being from Odessa, being from West Texas.
Well, I mean, we don't have a big music scene out here. That's one of the things.
In West Texas.
Yeah,
Not Texas in general.
Not Texas in general, no. But and definitely in West Texas, there's not a big music scene. So, I mean, it kind of sucks because I feel like we're very underrepresented out here. Because there are some very, very good musicians out here in West Texas, and I feel like they're underappreciated. And I don't know, maybe it's just because of the area. Our biggest area is Dallas, Texas, and Dallas, Fort Worth. So I don't really know. I don't know why it's like that, but it is what it is, I guess.
You know, we compare ourselves, I think, a lot to Nashville, and I'm talking Texas as a whole. And I'm hoping to see, just with technology, Texas music becoming more of a mainstream thing, because it's not the same as a Nashville Music Row type of country.
And no, yeah, absolutely.
I think too, with what you provide, with what Treaty Oak provides, I think it's definitely a unique sound, and I love it. I personally love it a lot, and I hope it really goes to mainstream. The Southern rock, I think, is something that does need to come back, and I wanted to tell you guys that. So, and how much I really, honestly, the No Vacancy, and we're gonna plug a lot of this. No Vacancy is a great album. How long did that take?
The process, of No Vacancy.
8 years.
8 years. Yeah. I mean, this guy was sitting on some of those songs
for a long time.
And some other songs, you know, they came out over the process of, you know, maybe less than, you know, maybe 3 to 4 months.
I mean, if you're talking about recording it, it's probably like 2-3 months.
The entire time in the studio, we recorded out here in Odessa, and worked with a guy who was very busy with his normal job, but he on the side had, you know, a studio in his house. And over the course of about 2 to 3 months, he was only able to record, you know, some Saturdays and some Sundays. We would go over there, you know, just as much as we could.
Yeah, basically we recorded it in the guy's living room. As far as the mixing and the mastering and getting everything down, it probably took about a month or two.
Congratulations. I mean, I really do hope for the success. And now I also will plug to the new single, Leaving Hell, here in a minute. But we have to pull over for the lightning round. I hope you're ready, strapped in, get ready. It's ready. All right. It's gonna get a little rough.
Dude.
All right, let's pull over. We're going to pull over the White Lightning for the lightning round. Before we get started, we love promoting local businesses. And I can't help it, but look at one of the hats there is the double R. Do you want to promote a local brand here with us today?
We'd just like to shout out Double R Company. And actually, this hat that I'm wearing here as well, it's from a company called Hometown Hat Company. And they do all types of small West Texas towns. They've got Fort Worth. All their hats are great quality, look great. Same thing with Double R. They've got a lot of great stuff.
Yeah, shout out to Double R. They hooked us up. So, yeah.
Yeah, no, I've heard they're great people. Really appreciate you plugging them today. We're promoting, for our local business, we're promoting our local coffee shop here. It's veteran-owned here in Lampasas. They're building a new location out in Round Rock, which is north of Austin. It's called Alamo Coffee. Are you all coffee drinkers? Because I feel like you might need some.
Yeah, I'm also a big Lampasas fan. My buddy has like a big ranch out there.
Oh, really? Well, hey, we get it done out here. The Yalus were a little crazy. But it's alamocoffee.com, and you can check out their social media. They got great coffee, but they got great merch too, great hats, and they're really doing a great thing for the community and first responders. Yes. So shout out to them.
Would love a good coffee right now.
I need some. Okay, here we go. Right. Treaty Oak Revival. What is your favorite word?
Fuck. All right, lightning round. Keep coming.
Least favorite word.
No.
I was thinking it was going to be 9 o'clock interviews on Zoom.
That's a close second.
Okay, Texas saying. We need a favorite Texas saying.
And I'd say the word that comes out of my mouth the most is y'all. I don't know if that's necessarily a Texas saying, but I'm born and raised here, and I've been saying it. You know, it's probably my second or third word out of my mouth.
From the north, if you go up to north, they say you guys and things like that. But y'all is so easy.
Use guys. Oh, this is weird. Yeah, it's definitely interesting. It's comforting when you're outside of the south.
I will never write an email at my job and say you all.
Yeah. So,
yeah.
Here we go. This is where it's going to get bumpy. We need you to pick one. And this is also a plug for your Chili Fest coming up. Randy Rogers Band or Co Wetzel? Who do you got?
Co Wetzel. Actually,
I enjoy Co, but he puts on a great show, and
it's
fun. But I'd go Randy Rogers.
Yeah, I'd go Randy Rogers too. That's the OG. Like, yeah. I can't disrespect them.
Yeah. We all love some Co, but gotta love some Randy Rogers. You're both in the White Lightning. You're driving coast to coast. You need a co-pilot right there in the middle between you. You know, where it's really awkward on that bench seat. You need
to be like Dumb and Dumber.
Exactly, yeah.
That's me and him, Dumb and Dumber.
What's the most annoying sound in the world? Here we go. We need a musician, dead or alive. Who do you got?
A musician, dead or alive. Man, for me, for
David Allan Coe, man.
For me, I'd have to say probably, John Mayer. Probably John Mayer.
Are those two completely different co-pilots? Because I feel like they are.
We both play the same type of music, but we both come from very different musical backgrounds of what we, you know.
I just think it would be fun to drive around with a very old David Allan Coe, who's like probably on some stuff. And
like the stories.
Yeah, I just want to hear the stories that he could tell. Man, Blake just wants John Mayer because he wants to pick his brain for a couple hours.
He just wants to know about that one. The body is a wonderland, and all the women that.
Yeah, he wants to learn about that. He probably already knows that.
You know, I think a great one would be Billy Joe Shaver. I mean, those original.
I love Billy Joe Shaver.
Those original, like, outlaw OG, you know, where they're just, like, not given a what, I think would be.
From the tour bus, man.
Okay, so either one. You got both David Allan Coe or you got John Mayer, but you got to play a song for them. Are you playing one of their own? Are you playing your own? Are you playing a deep cut? Are you playing just like some random song?
Nah, dude. If it's David Allan Coe, I'm probably like playing some Zeppelin or something like that. And as far as John Mayer, I don't know. He probably wants to listen to Stone songs.
Yeah, John may be like that. With John, I may put on... maybe some like Polyphia.
I'm not familiar. Polyphia?
Polyphia is a metal band, but they're extremely, extremely technical players. I mean, anyone listening, go look up Goat by Polyphia and your mind will be blown. Yeah, it's prog rock, basically, but on steroids and a little bit of drugs, probably.
Okay, so I'll make sure to take my LSD. And then I'll plug some
Hey, always make sure to take your LSD, okay?
That was prescribed by your doctor specifically.
Hold on, this is the kids show, so...
Only if your doctor does it.
That's right, okay. All right, y'all did great. That's the lightning round. So we got it ended on that note with taking LSD. But I wanted to plug your music, and that's what this is all about. You have a new single, Leaving Hell. Tell me a little bit about that.
We have a new... project that we're working on right now, and you know, we're really excited about it. We're kind of trying to dive more into the musical style, and I mean, we have really, really talented musicians. They're really good guys and they make some beautiful music. So we're really focused on the musical aspect of this album coming out. Obviously the lyrics will be where they need to be, but yeah, I think it's a beautiful thing. I think everyone's going to be really happy with it. If you're a real fan of our stuff, you're going to be even more of a fan of this new stuff coming out. So just stay tuned. It's going to probably take a while because we want to make sure that we get it where it needs to be. But it's kind of like a Christmas.
Yeah, absolutely. And I mean, even with that, you know, when we released Leaving Hell, I'm sure, you know, a lot of people were kind of surprised by the sound of that song, you know, comparably, you know, to the album No Vacancy. And so that was we kind of wanted that. And we just kind of want to be like, hey, we're kind of moving. The next album isn't going to sound all like that, but just to say, hey, we're moving kind of in a little bit of a direction. Here's kind of get your brain turning for what, you know, you could be hearing coming up.
It's very different. I mean, the style is different. The lyrics are different. The concepts are different. But I think it'll be something where if you are a true fan and you do love our music, you're going to love this.
Is it a full length or EP?
Full length album.
Yeah.
That's very cool. I've been doing this within a short time in terms of what you've had. And
we've had a bunch of people, you know, wanting it. So since the first album, people have been telling us, we want new music.
Yeah, about 2 weeks after the first album came out, people are asking where the new music was. We're like, hey, hold on. Hey, we're going to have to write it.
Yeah. Give us some time.
I hope we can see these late night sessions are paying off. We're all very excited. And so I wanted to tell everyone, too, you can catch these guys, use guys, but we can catch them at Chili Fest, April 1st and 2nd. You You're playing on the first date, is that right?
Yes, right. April 1st.
It's outside of College Station.
Yeah, it's in Snook, yeah, Texas. It's in Snook.
We've already mentioned a couple. Randy Rogers will be there. Coe Wetzel, I think, is headlining the next day. You got our good friend Joey Greer is also going to be there. We're all very excited, and hopefully we can actually make it out there to College Station, to Snook, Texas. All right, before we let you go, we just need to find out how we follow you. How do we listen to you?
Instagram, Twitter, Facebook. It's all pretty much at Treaty Oak Revival. Also, we have our website. We're on Spotify, Apple Music, all streaming platforms. Yeah, it's all at Treaty Oak Revival. And we have our website. So please, if you are looking for shows or events, please go to treatyoakrevival.com or follow us on our Instagram. That's where we'll be posting most of our dates. We hope to see y'all soon out at some shows and get rowdy.
Absolutely.
Well, we appreciate it. We can't wait for that new music, for the new album. We got to let you go. We love Odessa, but
We're going to be playing in Austin at
Rustic Tap.
Rustic Tap with Wyatt Weaver Band. So that's kind of close to Landastis if y'all want to go.
Absolutely. Do you have a date on that?
The 21st of May.
Okay.
We're also going to be playing at River Road Ice House in New Braunfels, March 5th. Yep. So if you want to come sooner than that.
Yeah, that's a great place. We might actually see you there. We love New Braunfels. Well, we can't wait. Unfortunately, we do have to kick you out. We appreciate you guys. But before we kick you out, all we ask is for a song. Is there any way we can get a song from you?
Yeah, we got a missed call. We did a little change up on an acoustic version, and we hope that y'all enjoy it.
All right, well, this is Treaty Oak Revival, Missed Call. I'm done and it's safe to- There you go. There's Treaty Oak Revival, Miss Call, Acoustic. Definitely check them out on social media. Go subscribe to their YouTube. That always helps. And we are also just welcome to all their dates of future shows. Make it out to Chili Fest. It's going to be a lot of fun. Appreciate you guys. Is there a message out there for all of our young Texas musicians that want to be like you and rock out?
Just be yourself. Yeah. And you'll get there.
Absolutely. I mean, there is, you know, faking it till you make it. But I mean, really authenticity, you know, that's what people enjoy to see is, you know.
And get ready because we're coming out with some new stuff. It's going to be pretty rad. So y'all stay tuned.
Well, we love Odessa. Y'all are good people. And if you're ever down the street in Lampasas, you let us know, okay?
Yeah, we'll give you a call, all right? You'll be our first cruiser.
All right, guys. Thank you so much.
All right, thanks so much, Nick. Take it easy.